The forests of California face unique challenges.
Many millions of acres of natural forest in California are not in a healthy condition.
The problem that we see in a number of the forests in California is that they're denser than they otherwise naturally would be because of over 100 years of fire suppression.
They're very susceptible to large-scale disturbance in the form of large-scale wildfires, insect outbreaks, drought, mortality.
Unfortunately, a vast majority of the western forests in the U.S. are under extreme fire risks. We're seeing millions of acres burn every year.
Unhealthy forests also directly impact our water.
Tens of millions of Americans across the western U.S. get their water from forested systems. And when those acres burn, it has major impacts on the water quality and the water quantity that feeds our cities, our businesses, and the development and livelihoods of the western U.S.
The good news is we know what needs to happen on the landscape. We just don't have all the funding and financing necessary to bring it to action.
The overstocked forests of California need to be treated. This can be accomplished by hand, by machine, and or with prescribed fire.
Unfortunately, it costs a lot of money to go in and do forest health treatments.
There's not enough money within the appropriated budget or contained in the forest products to pay for the work that needs to be done here.
It's not a science problem. They know what they're doing. We know what has to happen here. It's a finance problem because the funding is not really available.
In an attempt to find a market-based solution to an ecological problem, Blue Forest Conservation developed the Forest Resilience Bond.
It's really setting up a new and innovative financial structure that will help steward that land, which is a major challenge.
There's a huge multi-billion dollar need for forest fire risk reduction financing. And the Forest Resilience Bond is the only instrument actively addressing this need.
It provides fire risk reduction, water quality enhancements, while also providing an economic return for investors.
First, a forest restoration project is identified. Blue Forest Conservation then helps to find potential beneficiaries, such as utilities and private companies, who would benefit from the restoration. The bond investment can come from pension funds, insurance companies, and/or foundations interested in both forest health and earning a financial return.
We've never invested in anything like the Forest Resilience Bond because there's never been anything like the Forest Resilience Bond. That's why we're so excited to be part of this pilot project.
The area chosen for this pilot is within the YUBA watershed of the Tahoe National Forest.
The North YUBA River watershed is actually, I believe, the second largest undamaged, or call it pristine, watershed now in the Sierra Nevada Mountains in California. So it's a really important community resource to protect before something bad happens to it.
The first pilot is about 15,000 acres, which is approximately 10% of the entire watershed. Of that 15,000 acres, we're going to be going in and doing work on the ground at about 7,000 acres.
This looks like many other projects that the Forest Service completes. The main difference is we've brought in other stakeholders with their matching funds to help pay for this work, and we brought investors together to accelerate the pace and scale of this work. This is a project that could take 9 to 10 years to complete under normal Forest Service conditions. We're going to get all this work done in 3 years, and it's a fully funded project.
Working with the National Forest Foundation, the Forest Service is able to increase both the pace and scale of forest restoration through master stewardship agreements.
The National Forest Foundation is acting as an implementation partner to help assist the Tahoe National Forest with about a dozen forest health projects across the forest.
Forest Resiliency Bond is not a grant. It's actually a loan. And it's not a loan to the Forest Service, it's a loan to the administering partner, in this case, the National Forest Foundation. But what it enables is the ability to get work done immediately on the ground.
Because the National Forest Foundation receives funding through a forest resilience bond, it is able to directly pay contractors for the restoration work in a timely manner, while the Forest Service provides the project planning and oversight.
So by bringing together investors and a number of other groups that benefit from this forest health treatment work, we're able to create a public-private partnership that can get this work done more quickly.
And that's part of creating this new business model. Budgets are staying flat.
The many benefits of this work has attracted the attention of a diverse group of agencies and foundations.
Everyone that I talk to is excited about this. It really checks all the boxes in terms of conservation impact and business model.
We want to minimize sediment and debris inflows to our reservoir so we can provide long-term water reliability to our water users.
Also, as an insurance company, we've paid the claims for many of the fires that we've seen. So for us to be able to invest in something that's reducing the risk of wildfires is a win-win for us. We earn a good return and we do good for the community.
As the first pilot project gets underway, the hope is that this model will serve as inspiration for many more conservation projects.
So our hope is that the FRB is extremely successful and becomes adopted as just a standard way of financing.
It's already changed the way we do business on this forest, and it appears to be changing the way that we'll be doing business in the region and possibly Forest Service wide.
10 years from now, I'd love to be able to see literally hundreds of thousands of acres that have been restored using the Forest Resilience Bond, not just in California, but across the West.